Welcome, Dukes. You've made it to the end of your college journey. And what a journey it's been. You've learned, made friends, and have only just begun to accomplish amazing things. One of the first icebreaker activities that you engaged with at JMU was a game called Step In. Today, I'd like to invite you all to reflect on your JMU experience as you play one last time. I'm going to say a statement, and if it applies to you, you'll step into the circle. Step in if you throw in a purple or gold streamer at a JMU football game when the Dukes scored a touchdown. Yeah. Step in if you prefer E-Hall over D-Hall. Step in if you slept in ever and were late to class because of it. Step in if during your time here at JMU, you joined a club or organization. Step in if you transferred to JMU. Step in if here at JMU you found a mentor. Step in if you changed your major here. Step in if you've had more than 3 Carrier Starbucks trips in one day. Step in if you maybe struggled before finding success here. Step in if you are a first generation college student. Step in if you met your best friend here at JMU. Step in if seeing Duke Dog ever made you smile. Step in if you leaned on another student for support here at JMU. Step in if JMU has become your home. Now, after a long time, step in if you are a proud graduate of James Madison University.
This is JMU, a place, an atmosphere, a community you truly have to see for yourself. Here, the people who walk on these bricks enter as curious learners who care about growth, who care about others, who want to make a positive impact on the world. I experienced beauty, happiness, passion, and care from every person I interacted with. And that held true when I got here. It's real. It's like I pulled back the curtain to a campus unlike any other. I pulled back the curtain to my new home.
Congratulations, Duke's class of 2022. The last 4 years have been quite the journey.
From the frog dance 4 years ago to these final moments, please enjoy some of the highlights of the last 4 years during our time here at JMU. In the summer of 2018, JMU welcomed Dr. Tim Miller as the new Vice President of Student Affairs.
In the fall, the school year kicked off with the reopening of D Hall, rising JMU's ranking as number 3 in the nation for best campus food.
In November of 2018, our beloved Marching Royal Dukes made their fourth appearance to march in the 96th annual Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
In March of 2019, the Peace Corps announced that James Madison University ranked number 20 among large schools on the agency's list of top volunteer-producing colleges and universities.
In April of 2019, we began to digitize the Furious Flower Archives, a new model of integrated library support for a living academic center which makes the archives broadly accessible.
CAA champions everywhere. Men's soccer, swimming and diving, women's tennis, lacrosse, basketball, and softball Dukes continued to make us proud in their successful seasons.
In the summer of 2019, the first class of the Valley Scholars Program graduated, and 26 of those students enrolled at JMU for the fall.
For the 2018-2019 school year, JMU was named Virginia's number one most Instagrammed landmark, according to CBS. In August of 2019, Wilson Hall reopened its doors for classes. The renovated space in Wilson Hall marked a new chapter for the Department of History.
Home to 500 students, Paul Jennings Hall officially opened its doors in October of 2019 as JMU's newest dorm on campus.
Off to Frisco, JMU football kicked off the new year at the national championship.
For the 2019 to 2020 school year, we were number 2 for top public schools in the South from U.S. News and World Report.
Moving into fall 2020, the Center for Multicultural Student Services, the Office of Sexual Orientation, Gender Identity and Expression, and the Office of Disability Services joined together in SSC to form the new Student Affairs DEI area.
Duke's Dining opened to kick off the school year, and Starship robots descended onto campus to deliver food to dorms and offices.
In June, our softball Dukes became the first team in the CAA to participate in the Women's College World Series.
For the 2020 to 2021 school year, we were ranked number 1 most recommended public school in the U.S. according to Wall Street Journal and Times Higher Ed.
In the fall of last year, the Marching Royal Dukes and JMU football kicked off their 50th anniversary.
And the College of Business Learning Complex had its grand opening, boasting more than 200,000 square feet of new and renovated space.
In September, we rededicated 3 quad buildings, renamed to Gavin Hall, Darkest Johnson Hall, and Harper Allen Lee Hall.
In November, JMU announced our transition to the Sun Belt Conference.
And the DukeSat team launched HiSat-1, a high-altitude weather balloon that reached 60,000 feet and traveled over 100 miles.
As the fall semester came to a close, JMU men's basketball had a legendary win against UVA.
In 2022, for its 6th year, faculty and students from the School of Accounting prepared over 400 tax returns for low-income individuals as part of the Volunteer Income Tax Assistance Program.
In February, James Madison University's world-class academic excellence and national prominence was validated with a new Carnegie classification of R2 Doctoral University with high research activity through the Carnegie Commission. In March, we were finally back to our alternative spring break programs across the country.
This April, engineering students competed in the NASA Rocket Launch Competition, and King Hall, formerly known as ISAT-CS, was dedicated to Charlie King. For this school year, our rankings include number 1 best college in Virginia for getting a job for the 3rd year in a row.
And JMU was a top producer of Fulbright Scholars Week. These past 4 years have been quite eventful. Congratulations to the class of 2022. We did it.
Thank you. For your safety, emergency exits are identified with illuminated exit signs. Exits from the arena are located at all four corners of the main floor level. This facility is equipped with a fire alarm system. In the event of fire alarm system activation, all occupants must immediately leave the building by way of the closest emergency exit. Once outside, please move away from the arena so that emergency vehicles can safely and quickly make access. Do not re-enter the building until told by JMU police or fire department personnel.
Thank you.
welcome to the commencement ceremony for the College of Science and Mathematics. At this time, I would like to introduce the undergraduate candidates for the class of 2022. Would the undergraduate candidates from the College of Science and Mathematics please rise and remain standing? Will the audience please stand to recognize the faculty and the platform party and remain standing for the national anthem?
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming in the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air gave star-spangled banner yet waves.
Please be seated. Welcome to James Madison University. I am Jean Martino McAllister, Professor Emerita of Health Sciences in the College of Health and Behavioral Studies. I will be your Master of Ceremonies today. Good afternoon to our graduates, families and friends, faculty and administrators, and all of you who are here to celebrate the achievements of the class of 2022. Please join me in thanking Olivia Romini, who received her Master's of Music degree on Thursday for that wonderful rendition of the Star Spangled Banner. We want to make this a comfortable and safe environment today, so I would like to make a few announcements before we continue with the ceremony. I ask that members of the audience please turn off cell phones, beepers, pagers, etc. during the ceremony. The first aid station is located on the main concourse. Please ask one of our ushers if you need assistance. Restrooms are located on the main concourse. The concession stands, located on the main concourse, will have beverages and snacks for sale. The stands will remain open during the ceremony. No smoking is allowed in the Atlantic Union Bank Center. For the benefit of the graduates and their families, the university has a professional photographer who will be taking pictures of each graduate with the president. You will be contacted by the photographer regarding the purchase of these photos. Thus, we ask that family and friends remain in their seats during the entire ceremony. I now call on Dean Prinz for recognitions.
Candidates for graduation, family, friends, faculty, and staff. Welcome to the May 2022 commencement for the College of Science and Mathematics. I am Dr. Sam Prinz, Dean of the College of Science and Mathematics. I'd like to recognize those people who play a key role at James Madison University. Please hold your response until everyone has been introduced. Please stand as I call your name. First, I would like to recognize Jonathan R. Alger, President of James Madison University, Heather Coltman, Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, Lara Major, Rector for the Board of Visitors, Craig Welburn, Member of the Board of Visitors, Xavier Williams, student representative to the Board of Visitors. Thank you. You may be seated. I would also like to introduce Kathy Ott Walter, Speaker of the Faculty Senate, Nathan Wright, Interim Director of Biotechnology, Michael Renfro, Professor of Biology, Kyle Seifert, Interim Head of Biology, Luann Lovin, Interim Associate Dean and DEI Director, Stephen Whitmire, Interim Associate Dean, Lynette Watkins, Head of Chemistry and Biochemistry. I'm not going to keep it straight. Cassie Williams, Associate Professor of Mathematics and Statistics. Stephen Leslie, Head of Geology and Environmental Science. Marcus Davis, Associate Dean and Interim Head of Mathematics and Statistics. Christopher Hughes, Head of Physics and Astronomy. Tim Miller, Vice President for Student Affairs. Rudy Molina, Vice Provost for Student Academic Success and Enrollment Management. And Tawana Moore, Interim Vice President for Administration and Finance. Thank you. Would the faculty present please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Please be seated. And now I want to recognize an extraordinarily dedicated group of people whose sacrifice may not always be obvious, but who give themselves selflessly in service of our community and our country. Will our active service military and veterans of all branches stand if you are able so that we can express our gratitude? Thank you. Lastly, I would like to thank our ASL interpreters, Jen Diggins and Mona Mirapur, for their assistance this afternoon. We gather to recognize the culmination of several years of effort across multiple modalities. Your experiences within the College of Science and Mathematics have included hands-on development of knowledge and skills in the field, in the lab, in internships, in summer research experiences, at a computer, or with pen and paper. You may have traveled abroad or engaged in service learning more locally. You were supported by faculty who cared deeply about engaging you in meaningful and rigorous learning experiences, and by staff who supported your experiences and welcomed you with smiles. And let's not forget the support of your family and friends. Please join me in recognizing all of the community members that have supported you. There are a few individuals here today that I would like to specifically recognize, and I invite them to stand briefly as they're able. Dr. Nathan Wright is the recipient of the CSM Madison Scholar Award for 2022. This award is given to a faculty member who exemplifies excellence and scholarly achievement. Dr. Lynette Watkins received the 2022 CSM Distinguished Service Award, which recognizes exceptional professional related service to JMU, the profession, and the community. Drs. Michael Renfro, Grace Weingard, Cindy Kearns, John Gilgi, Richard Faust, Jim Sachaki, Deborah Warner, and Mr. Lon Jarvis, who are or have retired from service to JMU. Thank you for your years of service. I now welcome the sixth president of JMU, Mr. John Alger. President Alger is a nationally recognized scholar and speaker on higher education law and policy issues, such as civic engagement, free speech, and diversity. A lawyer by training, President Alger has devoted much of his career to issues related to diversity, access, and inclusion. He has consulted with organizations and institutions around the country on policies and procedures to enhance diversity and access. President Alger graduated with high honors from Swarthmore College and honors from Harvard Law School. Under his leadership, JMU developed a vision to be the national model of the engaged university, engaged with ideas and the world, and a strategic plan focused on engaged learning, community engagement, and civic engagement.
Good afternoon and welcome, students, families, friends, and colleagues, to the commencement exercises for the James Madison University College of Science and Mathematics. Yay, you guys. I'm so happy that we can be together today here and in person. And the weather is always good in the Atlantic Union Bank Center. Many people worked long and hard to make this ceremony possible, and I want to thank everyone who contributed to this moment. After these past couple of years, we will never again take for granted the ability to gather and celebrate in person. As we begin, graduates, take a moment and look around you. You made it, and you made it together. Even though we've spent a lot of time apart, we've never been more aware of how much we need one another and of how our lives are interconnected. Human relationships are at the heart of what we do here at James Madison University, and it's fitting that we join together in community, even as we recognize all of you individually for your accomplishments. You've each taken your own path to get here, but you are all Dukes now, and I'm excited to celebrate each of you as you cross this stage. I try to take a walk around campus almost every day, and I've noticed lately that more and more people are taking time to smile and say hello along the way. Some of you have even shared your plans for the future in those chance encounters. Now, it could just be the improved weather after a long winter, but I think these moments reflect the fact that we treasure human connection now more than ever. And those human connections here at JMU have equipped you with the skills and mindset to address the challenges that will come your way in the future. We've all been reminded that the world is full of uncertainty, but we've also experienced how we can all overcome seemingly insurmountable obstacles by working together and combining our talents. The past 3 years have been a stark reminder of how the individuals in this room are key to our collective future. Indeed, we have seen just how much we need your knowledge and skills. Scientists around our nation and the world stepped up like never before to develop safety protocols and vaccines in record time. And mathematical models were front and center in guiding public health and public policy decision making. As students in these fields, you found new ways to engage in scientific methods and experimentation. Of course, as you all know, innovation is built into the very nature of the scientific method. Those of you graduating today know that in order for science and math to benefit humankind, you need to be willing to test and retest your assumptions. It's only through trial and error that the greatest discoveries have been made. By definition, your disciplines require hard work, patience, resilience, and humility. I think the rest of the world could learn something if we were willing to follow the model of discovery present in the sciences. I've had the privilege of visiting some of your labs and watched as you explained scientific principles to children who may someday become JMU Dukes themselves. Many of you have done undergraduate research alongside our faculty and have presented your findings on campus, at conferences, or even in publications. You know that science is to be shared. In fact, many of you have worked with community members and organizations all around us to apply scientific and mathematical concepts to real-world problems. Thank you for sharing your time and talent in these ways. Now, you need to go out and share your gifts with the world. As graduates of James Madison University, you join a list of tens of thousands of alumni all over the nation and the globe who are being the change and making the world a better place. You have been tested, you have grown, and you are ready. Employers tell us all the time that they value JMU graduates because you bring that can-do spirit to the table. You are doers, problem solvers, and positive team members. Purple unites us here at JMU. And I hope you'll keep wearing your JMU purple with pride wherever you go. I can tell you from personal experience all over the world that it's a great way to meet people who are connected to the JMU family. And if you come back to campus, and I hope you will often, you'll find that there's always more purple in the bookstore. And no matter where you go, I hope you'll stay connected to your JMU family and community for the rest of your lives. Future generations of Dukes need you, so be ready to share your knowledge and wisdom with them in the years to come. And finally, you know that I will always implore you to dream big about what you can do and about the ways in which you can use your education and talents to serve the needs of the world around you. That is the calling of your lifetime. So keep dreaming big. Congratulations, everyone, and go Dukes!
The College of Science and Mathematics affords the honor of speaking at commencement to the faculty member who has received the college's Distinguished Teaching Award. This award is given annually to a single faculty member in recognition of exemplary teaching. Today, we're honored to hear first from Dr. Cassie Williams, Associate Professor of Mathematics and Statistics, who received the award in 2021. And then Dr. Michael Renfro, Professor of Biology, the recipient of the 2022 award.
Graduates, families and friends, faculty, I want to share a story with you. It's a very inspirational story, and I expect everybody here will leave wanting to follow my extremely sage advice. It's a story about cookies. You were supposed to laugh there. who here has heard of a digestive? So a few, okay. It probably sounds like something that you take when you've eaten something that didn't agree with you. Or it probably doesn't sound appealing, even if I tell you there's chocolate involved. A digestive is a type of cookie, a biscuit, as the Brits say, that's very common in the UK. It's basically a shortbread cookie with some wheat flour and coated in chocolate. And it's delicious. I ate multiple packs a day for like 4 months. So how did I discover digestives, you ask? By stepping into the unknown. Usually when you visit a new place for just a short time, you don't get to really experience the local culture through things like their grocery stores. But when you stay somewhere for 4 months or you have infants who need diapers, that changes. And if you're in a grocery store in London, you end up on the cookie aisle because cookies. I would never have known that these glorious, snappy, chocolatey nibbles existed had I not looked at the package and said, "That's a funny name for a cookie. I wonder what those are like." Over our long stay in London, we proceeded to visit grocery stores in each new place that we visited to check out the local cookie options. Many had packaging that we couldn't read. Some we can get here in Harrisonburg, and others aren't sold outside of that region. Let me be very clear, though, not every cookie that we tried was nearly as exciting as a digestive. We probably tried a dozen different kinds of cookies, and only maybe four really stood out. What about those others? Did we give up trying new cookies just because some of them were unimpressive? Of course not. Those failures were minor bumps on the road to cookie bliss, right? Those setbacks were learning experiences as we understood what we liked compared to the locals. The point is that we discovered something really great by stepping out of our comfort zone and trying something new and unknown, and by not being afraid to keep trying, even when we encountered a setback. Are cookies a sort of silly analogy for trying new things and persevering in the face of challenges? Absolutely. But it doesn't make it any less applicable to the choices and experiences in your own life. Dr. Carol Dweck, a psychologist renowned for her research on mindset and motivation, once said, "Why seek out the tried and true instead of experiences that will stretch you?" Those new experiences, especially the challenging ones, lead to growth. By living at the edge of your capabilities, you give yourself a chance to change what you are capable of. Learning from our failures is one of the most important life skills we can have. You've maybe already encountered an unknown, challenging situation slightly more intense than trying random cookies. Maybe you took a class unrelated to your major, or you did undergraduate research, or you studied abroad, or you joined a club where you didn't know anyone yet. Maybe you earned a low grade on an assessment, or you contaminated an experiment, or you said the wrong thing to a new acquaintance. Or maybe your step into the unknown is yet to come in finding a job, moving to a new place, taking on a new role in your organization, or making a new friend. Maybe you will fail epically in front of your new boss or miss a major deadline. Whatever comes next, I hope that as you leave the now not so unknowns of JMU, I hope you look for the new and unknown to try, even in small doses, like trying random cookies in the grocery store. I hope that you will take your missteps and your failures as a chance to grow and stretch and learn, as opposed to barriers to your future success. You never know what you'll find that you enjoy, or what you'll learn about yourself or the world, or what unimagined opportunities may arise from stepping away from your comfort zone, out of your planned path, and into the unknown. Thank you.
Congratulations, graduates of 2022. I'm happy to share this graduation with you because, in one sense, it's a graduation for me as well. You're graduating to your vocation, I'm graduating to my avocation. You're either seeking a job directly or preparing for your job through additional graduate or professional schooling. After 36 years, I'm retiring from teaching at JMU. We are both looking at new chapters in our life. As you go through life, try to learn something new every day. Thomas Huxley wrote, "Try to learn something about everything and everything about something." It's okay to be a specialist, but you're more interesting if you're something of a generalist as well. It's been my blessing to work at JMU because, in addition to being a researcher discovering knowledge and a teacher disseminating knowledge, I got to be a perpetual student, often learning from you, my students. And I love the diversity that exists at JMU. I've had students from Vietnam, China, India, Ethiopia, Estonia, England, Iran, Iraq, Kurdistan, Guatemala, and Ukraine. Slava Ukraini. And I've learned so much from you about culture and life. Beyond that, experience it for yourself. Whenever you can, travel to different countries. You will learn and experience unique things when you get beyond your own borders. As students of science and mathematics, we're used to seeking those things in life that can be observed and tested, measured and quantified. You will undoubtedly set objective goals in your life. I want you to think about affective goals as well. I want to speak for a moment about those things that can't be counted, but still count. As I think of ways to make your life more enjoyable, I have two recommendations. One is to learn to play a musical instrument if you don't already. Music is the universal language of humans, bridging all cultures and creeds. Even when we don't speak the same language, we can share music because music transcends cultural differences. Second, learn to dance. If music is the universal language, dancing is the universal expression of joy. Why sit it out when you can experience joy? Why would I give you this advice? Because life is not about trudging to a destination. It's about enjoying the journey. In his song, In Tall Buildings, John Hartford has the lyrics, "Now when I retire and my life is my own, I made all the payments, it's time to go home, and wonder what happened betwixt and between when I went to work in tall buildings." Don't be that person that looks back and says, "Where did all the years go?" Be that person that looks back and says, "What a blast I had. I was president of the Virginia Academy of Science. I also, along the way, was president of the Shenandoah Valley Banjo and Fiddle Club. What a blast that was. As I studied science, I also studied blues music with John Cephas and Ann Rabson. As I learned new scientific methodologies, I also learned Argentine tango from Homer and Christina Lattice. My wife and I danced an Argentine tango for our wedding dance. Music and dance can bring such joy to your life. And as you travel through life's journey, don't forget to express gratitude. Why is gratitude important? No one gets where they're going alone. We have all had a lot of support along the way, even in ways we don't realize. You've been supported all your life by your parents, whether you realize it or not. Support comes in many forms and is expressed in many ways. Be grateful to your parents, for they've helped shape who you are, sometimes just in building resilience and independence, but hopefully mostly through love, support, and encouragement. Be grateful to your professors who have helped train and educate you. You will never know how much time and effort went into preparing the lectures and laboratories that they shared with you, or how much they celebrate your successes and agonize over your failures, which are really just setbacks that they help you overcome. Think of your favorite professors, and before you leave, tell them how grateful you are to have had them in class or lab. Just as you have favorite professors, we have students for whom we've come to care deeply. And believe me when I tell you, we would love to stay in touch with you and share your future life events and successes. Just because you're graduating does not mean we stop caring about you or forget you. I have lifelong friends who are former students of mine, and I'm grateful to see them get jobs, get married, have children, and on at least one occasion get to teach their child in college. I remain friends with former professors of mine who were meaningful in my life, my entomology professor, my Spanish professor, my forestry professors, and I honor those who are no longer with us because they are part of me now. I was grateful for what they taught me, not only in the classroom, but about life, and they continue to inspire me today. So don't be afraid to share your gratitude. It means more to others than you realize and will be repaid manyfold. Finally, stay curious. Continue to challenge yourself. Don't be afraid to reach for the impossible. You might find it to be only improbable. Then it becomes just possible. Then it becomes another accomplishment, and look what you did. Make the planet a better place because of your presence. Congratulations, and enjoy your day and your life.
Thank you, Dr. Williams and Renfro, and congratulations on your recognition. I'd like to recognize the graduates. In particular, two biology majors, Benjamin Nick and Madison Silo, who each earned the honorific of JMU valedictorian. Please stand if you're able. I'm going to call a few more names. Please stand as you're able. In addition, graduates Sarah Babcock, Jose Alavado Alavranga, Olivia Muma, Ashley Odhas, Trinity Perry, Emily Marsh, Lily Whitman, Bradley Ferrer, and Griffin Adams. All of these graduates have been recognized with Dean's Outstanding Senior Awards. Congratulations to all. You can sit down. Thank you. I now welcome Dr. Heather Coltman, JMU Provost, to the podium, a solo and collaborative concert pianist who earned her Doctorate of Musical Arts from the University of Texas. Dr. Coltman has performed, recorded, taught, won awards, and lectured across 5 continents.
Thank you. It is such a pleasure to be here with you this afternoon celebrating this marvelous day. As JMU's Chief Academic Officer, I am so proud to represent our exceptional faculty, the heart and soul of JMU. I now call on Dr. Kathy Ottwalter, Speaker of the Faculty Senate, and Associate Professor of Health Sciences, who will endorse the graduation candidates on behalf of the faculty.
Thank you. The faculty at James Madison University is pleased to endorse the candidacy of these members of the class of 2022 for bachelor's degrees. On behalf of the faculty, I request Dr. Coltman to present the candidates to President Alger for conferring of their degrees.
Students who have achieved a grade point average of 3.5 or higher are highlighted in the college ceremony program within their designated college. These are designated as summa cum laude, magna cum laude, and cum laude. These honors graduates can be identified by the gold cords they wear. Will those students graduating with Latin honors please rise as you are able and be recognized for your academic accomplishments? Thank you. You can be seated. Honors College graduates are recognized for completing an enhanced interdisciplinary honors curriculum, including a senior honors capstone project. These students are wearing special Honors College medallions. Students who completed an honors thesis requiring research in their academic major are also listed in the program as graduating with distinction for the discipline in which the thesis is completed. I would like to give these graduates the extra acclaim they deserve, so I ask the Honors College students to stand as you are able and be recognized by our applause. And now will all the candidates from the College of Science and Mathematics who are earning undergraduate degrees please rise. President Alger, it is a pleasure to present the undergraduate degree candidates for the May 2022 ceremonies. They have fulfilled all academic requirements, have been approved by the faculty, and are entitled to receive the appropriate degrees.
Are you ready? These are the magic words. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Virginia and the Board of Visitors of James Madison University, I now declare that you are graduates of James Madison University. With all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities afforded you under your degree and as alumni of this university.
Graduates, in the academic tradition, you may now turn your tassels from right to left. Congratulations! You may now be seated.
The degrees being awarded today from the College of Science and Mathematics are the Bachelor of Arts and the Bachelor of Science. We will now individually recognize those graduates from the College of Science and Mathematics.
Good afternoon. My name is Kyle Seifert. I'm the interim head of biology. Would the degree recipients from the Department of Biology please come forward?
Gino Alexandro Abad. Moyesere Alubusala Abidaba. Landon Cole Alston. Brenda Lisette Amaya Lopez. Patrick Michael Ames. Nicole Rose Arena, Brianna Caitlin Escenero, Albion Azari, Sarah Elizabeth Babcock, Bailey Lee Geneva Baker, Sydney Lee Baker, Megan Lee Barlow, Connor Thomas Bastidas, Alexandra Catherine Black, Chesney Ann Benson, Elizabeth Blake Bogun, Lily Malina Bose, Elizabeth Caroline Boyd, Adam Strother Boyle, Kate Elizabeth Bradley, Emma Francis Brennan, John Francis Burkhart, Austin Browning Cahill, Grace Soa Chang, Liam Grady Chang, Ryan Truman Clary, Megan Amelia Davis, Alyssa Ann Dela Vega, Darmi Kalpesh Desai, Jacob Jean Dragovich, Morgan Simone Dufault, Rachel Nicole Dull, Abigail Michelle Duval, Julia Christine Emmons, Bethany Caitlin Eppard, Rebecca Ann Falkenstein, Kylie Alexandra Finneran, Nathaniel Hinton Flynn, Emily Noel Fowler, Morgan Ashley Foy, Samantha Tuwen Fulton, Ashley Nicole Funkhauser, Brenna Mary Gannon, Anna Marie Gino, David Jackson Greenspun, Madison Jolene Gregory, Emma Lauren Heslop, Christopher James Ho, Allison Ann Hoffman, Michael James Houston, Heather Marie Hull, Lauren Simone Jackson, Paris Michaela James, Isabel Ray Keneally, Benjamin David Nick, Katarina Anna Knudsen, Nicholas Richard Kalecki, Catherine Marie Cormatis, Maxwell Connor Coutil, Jill Louise Lang, Austin Alexander Latimer, Livia Jade Leiter, Gwyneth Juliana Lehman, Joseph Lemaster, Ling Mi Lin, Juliana Michelle Lincoln, Virginia Ruth Lopez, Allison Noel Majors,
Patrick Sean Maloon. Karis Alexandra McIntyre. Elizabeth Ann McLaughlin. Hunter Nicole McWilliams. Kirsten Abri Merica. Savannah Meyer. Zachary J. Miner. Catherine Lynn Motley. Jacob Tanner Muhlenbrook. Lisa Mickey Mullins. Nader Farid Namey. Nicole Briggs Musa. Lauren Ashley Nazarian. Nicholas Anthony Nettemeyer. Michael Viet Gwynn. Dorcas Bodema Obeng. Marcella Alejandra Oliva Rivera. Solomon Chukwemika Onyejekwi. Lincoln Oriana. Emma Faith Oren. Lauren Julia Palombi. Alexa Sophia Paredes Idiakis. Carlton Lamont Parker Jr. Angela Chantel Pence. Chelsea May Pence. Sarah Elizabeth Penrod. Diana Marie Polovic. Kaylee Virginia Rathbun. Caitlin G. Rogers. John Lawrence Ryan. Kian Shargi Safari. Eduardo Jose Salazar Gallardo. Lance Knight Schneider. Ashley Nicole Schutz. Annie Louise Swiger. Tyler Labiaga Sconing. Anna Trinity Sears. Saida Readme Shamsuddin. Kiyasha Dashe Short. Anna Kate Shutak. Caitlin Maria Smith. Madeline Noel Smith. Courtney Noel South. Jake Aaron Taylor. Anna Marie Francis Thibodeau. Bao Gia Tran. Jacob Russell Trout. Liam Thomas Turner. Rose Camille Vanderhorst. Morgan Deborah Vance. Samuel Isaac Van Tassel. Michelle Marie Vericocia. Sydney Patricia Wagner. Jason David Walters Jr. Emily Catherine Watts. Rachel Marie Watts. Isaac Ian Weatherilt. Emily Catherine Wells. Ashley Nicole Wickham. Shay Faith Widlacky. Ashley Marie Wilkins. Catherine Rosemary Williams. Connor Patrick Worth. Rachel Brianna Yetter. Maya Claire Yorks. Jenna Lee Zabinski.
Hello, my name is Nate Wright. I am the interim biotechnology director. Will the degree recipients from the biotechnology program please come forward?
Amar Yesser Ali. Jose Efrain Alvarado Alvarenga. Ryan Patrick Brooks. James David Clifford. Mallory Ellen Cunningham. Santhosh Dazari. Kurt Benjamin Espinoza. Tyler E. Gandy. Caitlin Grace Gathright. Liam Paul Augustine Godbold. Lakey Iman Green. Andrew Scott Jacox. Ryan Elizabeth Coons. Julia Lazariva. Amber Lynn. Mary Kate McNeil. Shannon McLandrick. Isabel Miriam Romov. Easton Osborne Roop. Kiera Elizabeth Swartz. Mohammed Tamir Shema. Lauren Ann Soleo. Lucy Catherine Utz. Osha Obaid.
Good afternoon. My name is Lynette Watkins. I'm the head of the Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry, and I welcome all the graduates from the Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry to please come forward to get your degrees.
Jonathan Edward Hayes. Gianna Elizabeth Mariello. Trinity Susan Perry. Jessica Lauren Berry. John Morgan Brimer. Emily Ann Burdage. Abigail Nicole Collins. Annie Niver Davis. Christina Michelle Dedayo. Samuel Lord Dimitri. Cameron Shaloy Dudek. Lissa Ann Garber. Rachel Lynn Irvin. Sophia Claire Jackanowski. Sean Patrick Lewis. Matthew Thomas McDowell. Katarina Marcou. Lynn Eleanor Marsh. Stefan Gorgiev Mihailov. Jacob Michael Motley. Liv Muma. Daniel Paul Musiketh. Nader Farid Naimi. Ashley Elizabeth Aldis. Cole Lewis Pate. Isaac Drake Paragoy. Toshi Murano Poe. Michaela Brianne Riney. Clayton Joshua Rogers. Justin McLean Sharp. Rachel Jane Stagmeyer. Rachel Elizabeth Walsh. Leanne Rose Weber. Paul Michael Wilson. Elijah J. Wajila.
Good afternoon. I'm Steve Leslie, head of geology and environmental science. I see you're already here, but with those that are going to get degrees from geology and environmental science, please come forward.
Paul Joseph Campion. Danielle Lynn Goodman. Duncan Stephen Hanna. Courtney Ann Johnson. Lily Rose Whitman. Joshua Michael Bateman. Cameron Michael Dodson. Emily Ann Marsh. Anna Marie Michoni. Colleen Ann Mulligan. Ethan Christopher Pembianchi. Rachel Barbara Phelps. Austin David Stickles. Hunter William Swedish. Zachariah Cole Thomas. Jennifer Rose Weiss. Jacob Ryan Whitlock. Dylan Henry Williamson. Madeline I Ching Young.
Hello, I'm Marcus Davis, interim head for the Department of Mathematics and Statistics. Would the degree recipients from the Department of Mathematics and Statistics please come forward?
Juan Aguirre Arellano. Daniel William Ballou. Kevin Richard B. Jaron Zion Billups. Alexander Thomas Bunting. An Lan Chow. Ru Chen. Zachary Landon Clark. Daniel Joseph Gardner. Kayla Elizabeth Gerber. Shreyas Kara. Emma Jean Knaus. Dawson Reese Lazarchek. Katie Elizabeth Lorenzo. Julian James Moran. William Robertson Nettles IV. Castor Romeo Rosario. Francisco Roberto Sanchez Vega. Ryan Spencer Schumann. Bajo Zella Teteth. Riley Alexandra Adler Tickle. Noah M. Tressler. Anna Capri Anello. Aaron Marie Cochran. Christopher Edward Klopp. Bao Von Gwynn.
Good afternoon. I am Christopher Hughes. I'm the head of the Department of Physics and Astronomy. Would the degree recipients from the Department of Physics and Astronomy please come forward?
Griffin Fraser Adams. Michael Marion Brown. Nathan Ryan Brown. James Alexander Claybo. Liam Alexander Downey. Camden Michael Dewey. Christopher Thomas Eaton. Corey Yale Jones. Elizabeth Susan Kohler. Daniel Paul Kalecki. Matthew Joseph Maines. Elizabeth Ann Moore. Daniel John Rossi. Kusha Sultani. John Michael Tamaro. Tyler Wayne Valentine. Christopher Andrew Whitehouse.
One more round of applause for all of the graduates of 2022.
Following the alma mater, we ask that the audience remain standing for the recessional of the faculty and the platform party. We ask that you meet your graduates outside of the Atlantic Union Bank Center on the Alumni Plaza. The alma mater, which was written by the late JMU faculty member, Dr. James R. Riley, will be led by Olivia Romini. Please stand for the alma mater and remain standing for the recessional.
Madison, James Madison, will be forever true. Our loyalty will always be to JMU. While friends remain within our hearts and not thank you.